Oh my God, you guys hear that? Okay, so to help us just discuss a little bit about the body orientation, so I brought in my little friend. Oh my God, oh my God. She's so excited. Hello, hello, hello everybody, and welcome to Exercise 2 of Bio23 Laboratory. Today we will be talking about external anatomy. We will first have to learn a few terms that you may come across in your lab manuals, particularly referring to the animal's body orientation. So I asked a little bit of help, so you can just check out the little snippet that I've left. I brought with me my very lovely baby to help us understand animal body orientation. Particularly, we're talking about vertebrates that exhibit bilateral symmetry. Let's discuss a few of the terms that you will encounter in your exercises. The first term would be dorsal. The one that's oriented facing the sky is the dorsal side. The one that is oriented facing the ground is your ventral side. This is the dorsal side. This would be her ventral side. The belly side would be her ventral side. Next, we also have terms like anterior or posterior. Achoo. Anterior would be at the front, the one that's facing the front. Posterior, that would be the back, right here at the rump. So for animals like dogs, like for coffee here, her anterior side is also her cephalad or her cranial side. Cephalad means near the head. Caudad would be closer to the tail. Now let's proceed to, of course, proximal and distal. This is in reference to the center of the body. So when we say something is proximal, that means it's closer to the center. And when we say something is distal, it means it's farther away. For example, we can say that the upper arm is more proximal compared to her paw. Distal would be farther away from the center. So again, her paw is more distal compared to her upper arm. That's it for animal body orientations. I'm gonna let her down now because she's getting very skittish, okay? For this exercise, you will have four main representatives of different vertebrates. So you have a fully aquatic organism, a semi-aquatic organism, two terrestrial organisms, but one of which can supposedly also access the air or the sky. You want to be able to identify the different parts of these organisms. But apart from that, what I'd really hope for you to actually also reflect on or to do while you're identifying parts is to relate this to the function. There's a reason why they look so different from each other. Try to think about not just the part per se, but actually also the form. Like, what is its shape, its size, surface area? That means how far it's spread out. Or its volume. And when you have a good idea of the form, you can actually relate that to the function. What exactly is this part used for? Is it used for movement? Is it used to regulate body temperature, exchange nutrients, or, you know, basically substances with the environment? Or is it used for navigation, just for the organism to sort of orient itself in its environment? Why is it important to know about the external anatomy? Because for one, you can't talk about it if you don't know what it's called. The art of identifying parts.
Head and shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes. So yeah, paa, tuhod, balik at ulo.
These are some of the first things that we're actually taught when we are children, because at some point, we are going to have to know how to talk about these things. Could I just not memorize these parts and not talk about these parts? But you can't, because you have very similar parts. If you go to a doctor and you want to complain about a certain pain that you're feeling, but you don't know what to call that part, so how are you going to tell the doctor?
Masakit yung ano ko eh. Ano nga yun? Basta yung ano.
And we see a lot of people having difficulty articulating or expressing how they feel if we look or if we compare different species of animals. Oh my God, there's so many parts to memorize, you know, so many things to look at. You know, they look so different. There's a bottom line. Whatever it is that their bodies are designed to look like, either way, they're designed for movement. You and I, we are both animals. And so from time to time, we should go ahead, get up off of that seat, celebrate the fact that your body is designed particularly to move through space. Just a quick disclaimer. I do not own some of the images in this video, and I basically found them thanks to Google image search. And also, this video is brought to you by talagang may sponsors na, the Department of Biology, College of Arts and Sciences, University of the Philippines, Manila. And it's mainly intended for edutainment purposes. If you weren't entertained, then educational purposes na lang po. No animals were harmed in the making of this video. So you guys have fun with your experiment, and I will see you real soon.